and that we shouldn't do. I'd like to put Mr. Clampett at ease here as far as Buckeye is concerned, because if Buckeye, I said this was a program of the people and for the people and by the people, and if Buckeye elects to retain their school as is, they have, I don't know of a law in the world that'll take it away from them, even under this plan. All that they do, if Buckeye votes to retain their school, all you do is draw a line across there, and it'd be just like it is.
Mrs. Faust, you want to say something.
Well, I don't think we can wait until these people get this tax question settled, because in the meantime, our boys and girls are growing up, and I think each district should get down to work and try to improve their own school. And I'm very proud of what Hubbard has done in the last 5 years.
Let's not have any commercials.
But I said we had a small independent district of 8 sections, and we called representatives in from the different rural districts and talked the school question over. And in Grant Township, they closed all their schools, and now we have just one left in Tipton. Tuition students are 56% of our enrollment. And the cost of the tuition pays approximately 50% of the general expenses. Another thing is that we let representatives come in from these districts and sit in on the school board meetings so that they can know what's going on and so they can go back to their districts.
Question?
Tell.
Mrs. Faust, don't you think that we ought to...
Will you stand, please, Rex, so we can hear
you? Don't you think that we ought to give them a chance to vote for their directors, these people that have tuition pupils?
Sure.
Don't you think they ought to belong in a school district where they can have something to say about the management of the school and vote for the directors?
I think it would be nice, but our laws don't provide it. And I said, as we found out, we have to wait a long, long time for these certain laws to be passed. And as I said, in the meantime, we have to have a good education.
Just a minute, please. I'd like to hear from Paul Glenny. Paul's from Union, and we've not heard from Union. We've heard from Witten.
Well, I've been enjoying this, taking it all in great shape. We don't want this...
Paul, would you talk to these people? I can't vote tonight, so I'm not a citizen of this group. Would you talk to them, please?
We don't want this hurried until our Union girls get through the state tournament, as far as that's concerned.
I got it in.
What is this?
And they've got us sold into Eldora. They've got a bill, and we've got them. And we can teach anything that they can. We're going to dislocate, smash, and ban and stuff. That's coming. But that's a silly math. Why, if we didn't have the facilities, I wouldn't say...
You mean with the pictures he drew?
Well, sure. If we didn't have the facilities, I wouldn't say a word.
Well, he isn't much of an artist, is he?
Understand. I didn't say this was the final map, and I don't think you can draw the final map until we just do a lot of good, hard study. And I think those questions you're raising, Vern, are the very ones we need to take into consideration. No study has been made. Where are our facilities, and where are our students in Hardin County? That's one thing we don't know positively, and I agree. I don't have any idea that this map comes within gunshot.
Harold, would you back up so we can all see that map?
Well, after what you said about it, I'm not very proud. I think I'll sit down.
Carl?
Yes.
Trouble, the whole reorganization plan.
How are you going to get those outside districts in? I can't figure it out. And I've talked to several of them. Sure, they want to come to WOS, they want to put us in their plan, see? But listen, when they come right down to voting, they're not going to vote in there on account of the millage. What are you going to do? I can't see where we make much headway on it.
Well, that comes
You're coming right back to the plan that I suggested, or the problem that I brought up. That's fundamental, and you can't do a thing about it. Other states are doing it. Iowa is one of the most backward states of solving that problem there is. Here I have the millage rate as they use it in Minnesota, the neighboring state over here. And they solve that problem somewhat by evaluating the different kinds of property on a different basis. Just a few of them, livestock and agricultural too, are valued at 20%, other property 40%. Non-farm homesteads 40%, rural homestead 20%, and so on down the line. Then when you put a flat millage on it, it falls somewhat in equal responsibility to the burden that it has to bear. But we don't do things like that here in Iowa. We haven't got the fundamental problem solved that we can go ahead with any reorganization plan. And I don't think that Hardin County farmers will be stupid enough to vote any plan until you've got that.
Right here, Wendell.
Well, Paul mentioned basketball. My wife said I wasn't supposed to bring that up, but I did want to ask Ben.
You've been coached?
How many times have you played basketball in the last 25 years?
Well, how many times have I played basketball in the last 25 years? That's a good question. I think I've played one game in the last 25
good.
Years,
well,
and I'll tell you what. Well, who that was against? That was against our own girls' team. The dads played the girls.
Uh-huh.
And in that way, we raised money to send the girls down to Des Moines so they could look on, and the next year they took the state championship.
That's what we did. What I'm getting at is merely this. A good high school, like you see there at Ackley, would offer something that we, when we get to your age and my age, can handle. And look at golf, for instance, there. And even dancing, I understand, they put that under athletic some places.
I'd like to answer Mr. Clampett on that, as far as the extracurricular activities are concerned. Let me ask you, in any large school, what percentage of the pupils participate in the extracurricular activities? What percentage of the pupils in a high school participate in all the subjects offered? There are only a limited amount. In a large school, I'm telling you that the farm children who live miles and miles away from the school under the plan presented over here wouldn't participate at all because they would be too far away. You ask, what would golf do as far as golf is concerned? I don't think that you need to go to high school to learn to play golf. And I don't think you need to go to high school to learn to swim. And I don't think you need to go to high school to learn to fix a tractor. Because when you start that, you're either talking trade schools or else you're just talking athletics and extracurricular activity. Now we ought to decide which way we're going.
Well, Ben, I'd like to ask you this one question, if I might. This program that you have mapped up here is not even a tentative program, is it? You've never referred it to the various school districts.
It's a tentative map.
I want to talk now. I felt sort of like a referee tonight. I can at least get a job refereeing fight, can't I? The whole town's been talking, but now it's time for the whole town talking vote, which you hope and I hope will stir your county and my county to some kind of action. Now, I want you to put your fingers on the little vote buttons there. Notice if you put your finger on the vote button, put your hand over it, it's going to be a secret ballot. Nobody will see it. Now, don't jiggle it and vote twice, but just put your hands on it. Now, once again, very briefly here, I'm going to try to say this. If you stay put, you keep things as they are. You keep the 53 school districts. The farmer out there with no voice and sort of taking a free ride, it means no enlargement, no consolidation or absorption. It's staying put, I believe, is represented by some of the men in the back there. I saw nod their heads at times. Now the 11 district school that Ben has proposed is coming from the school board, is that right? As coming from the school board, reduces the number from 53 to 11 districts. It keeps all the high schools, but closes the one-room schools. Now, each high school district absorbs the rural areas around it, and farmers, instead of paying tuition, pay an equal share of taxes, but they have a vote on the school boards, which they don't now have. Now, the 5 to 8 districts that have been presented, and don't label him with this, nor Ben or anybody else, the 5 to 8 districts presented by Carl Hamilton, it may be more, he said, it is that the county is to provide a detailed survey and then decide on the basis of that detailed survey on how many there could be, 5, 6, 7, or 8. And it would mean closing some high school. It's up to the people through their boards to decide which ones to close. Now you may vote, and please, when I say begin vote, hold the buttons down, take your time to make this decision until I say the word. Are you ready? And you'll have 15 seconds. Are you ready for this vote? On your mark, ready, set, go. That's 5. Are you voting? Take your time. This is a symbolic vote. 10. And it is 15. Hold it now while I count it. Is this right? 1, 2. 2 there, and 1, 2, 3, 4. Is there 5 there? 6 there. 1, 2, 3. Is that right? 3. 2, for stay put, six for 11 districts, and three for the 5 to 8 districts.